the last talker. Speaker, I just want to say a word about Brid, because Spark don't run on a low budget. Spark runs on no budget, absolutely no budget. We have a bucket going round. If you have a euro, put it in. If you don't worry. But we run on no budget. We didn't even have a banner for today. And if it wasn't for Brid Smith, we'd still have no banner. So I just personally want to thank Brid.
You're welcome, Louise. And I've been very humbled by watching you women over the last few years, how despite all the odds, you've stuck with this campaign, and absolutely well done to you. I just want to respond to a couple of things, because nearly everything's been said. Who here knows what a Scandinavian childcare system looks like? Well, I do. I'm not boasting about it. But my little sister had two boys in Sweden. And over the years, when I've gone over to see those young fellas grow, one of them has just graduated, done his equivalent of the Leaving Cert. As little boys, they went to creche, to a state-run creche, funded and run by the local authority, where all the staff were fully trained and vetted by the local authority. And they attended that creche from 9 in the morning until 4 in the afternoon, where they learned languages and they played and they had hot lunches and they had snoozes in the afternoon. And that cost my sister the princely sum of €1 per day per child. And her husband was earning good money, an air traffic controller. Then when they went on to further into national school, and all that was fully funded by the state system in Sweden. That's what a Scandinavian system looks like. How do they do it? Because they make the rich pay their taxes. That's how they do it. They don't have a Dennis O'Brien like we have. They don't have a Bono who lives offshore and refuses to pay the profits that they make here. And that's what we need to be learning from the Scandinavian childcare system. It is possible if you make them that have it pay. And it really stands to the kids when you have it. The second thing I want to talk about is the disgraceful behaviour of some media pundits like Adrian Kavanagh, encouraging the population to have a go at lone parents. And people mentioned it here today, and they're hurt and insulted and offended by it. Well, I know I've heard the same mantra in relation to refugees, in relation to immigrants in this country. And what that amounts to is people who are frustrated by this society, who don't feel that they can kick at them in there or kick above them, so they try to kick at those who they perceive below them. It's called Tuppence Ha'penny looking down on Tuppence. And it has to stop. It has to stop, because that sort of divide and conquer does not serve any of us any good. I don't believe, however, that they represent the majority of ordinary decent people in this country. I think what represents the majority of ordinary decent people in this country and their desire for equality was the outcome of the recent referendum. That's the spirit, and that's what the journalists should be encouraging, not the namby-pamby looking down on Tuppence attitude. The very last word I have is for Joni herself. I mean, it's getting embarrassing. Richard said it earlier on, you guys proved that everything she was doing was going to drive women further into poverty, into homelessness, into desperation, out of work. Yeah. Right? It's all been proven, and she continues to do it. All the predictions that Louise and Leah and the women of Spark are making are going to come true. She ought to be mortified. And my advice to her is this: Joan, you're in a hole. Either stop digging or throw yourself in the hole and bury yourself.